Hi everyone, welcome to Python Learning Series for Network Engineers. This is the third video on how to do Fortigate CLI automation using Python. In the second video, we have seen how to initiate SSH to Fortigate using Netmiko and send a configuration. So we are framing the configuration from a CSV file. So this was the file we used, iplist.csv. Here we have name and IP address, and using this CSV file we were framing the configuration within Python and sending into the device. So using that, we have created some objects here. We'll verify that. So these objects are created using the previous script. I'll be adding the complete playlist URL in the description and notification. So now in this script, what we'll do is we will try adding all these objects into a group, particular group. You can see I have added groups also here in addition to IP address. So this IP will get assigned to IP underscore group 1, and IP address 4 and 5 will get assigned to group 2. And I already have created groups here, so you can verify it. Now to add these addresses into group, we need to add additional lines to the command. So this is a command syntax for adding to the group. So here you can see I'm just creating an object IP underscore 101, assigning one IP, and then adding it to the group IP underscore group 01. Let me just try running this script, and this object, if you see now, there is no references, so we'll try executing manually. I'll paste the command. And let me refresh this page. And you can see now it assigned to one group, IP group 01. And you should be able to see IP underscore 101 here as well. So same logic we are going to use within Python now. So let me copy this script where we were reading CSV and framing the commands. In the same script, we will add additional logics, the commands whatever we have added. So these four lines we will add there. So I have one more file here, which is 03 fortigate cli add group. So here I'll paste it. And to execute this, we need dict reader. So from CSV import dict reader, and to add delay, we need time. I'll do a print here. This will add 2 seconds delay. Yeah. Frames configuration for each user. Now we will try reading another file, which is IP list group. group.csv, and I'll copy and paste additional commands. Okay, how to convert this into strings? Then we need to find out the variables required. So here you can see the additional variable required is the group name, and the group name is going to be group. So I can just give it in this way. I'll copy this and I'll make it as a formatted string f, and I'll give us group. And here again it is just going to be the name, so I can copy and paste here. This is also going to be a formatted string. So let us try running the script. Yeah, now it is framing complete configuration. User 1, user 2, each member it is appending to the respective group. You can see it is the last two got assigned to group 2. Now we can just add our SSH logic to the same script. Paste it here, and once we have SSH, now let us try running the script. Before that we'll verify. So IP group 1 doesn't have any of these user IPs and there is no reference, so we'll try running it. Yeah, it got connected to the device and you can see there is a 2 seconds delay I added here in each execution. So it is adding each IP into the respective groups by reading this CSV file. Now we'll go and verify that in the firewall. You can see here first 3 IPs got added into IP group 1 and 4 and 5 added into group 2, and here also you can see the references for the individual groups. In the next video we'll see how to find an object with IP address. So what is the object ID for a particular IP? For example, if you want to find out object ID of this particular IP, you can just give the IP address as an input and script will go and find out the object ID. I hope this video was helpful. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.